And welcome back to Flexible Games, where we are playing FortressCraft Evolved in Rush Mode. We are near to it here. We've got 121, 22, so we need like, now we have 23, so we need like three more of the components, and we should be good, which means I'm pretty sure we can get rid of the turntables that are in here, and that will stop the production and allow a little bit of backlog to come in so I can start collecting this stuff. I'm going to tear down the gold because I'm going to actually use the gold for missiles, and the nickel I can take out completely because I need this space for gold production. It's like that. If I do need a, you know, a touch here and there more, I can always craft them later. So there's the four that we need right there. All right, we have some titanium that we can, you know, stock up. I'd like a lot of this stuff coming through here to get stored up. So, oops, that was the wrong thing. That can go there, and that can go there. So I'd like, you know, a little bit of backlog to come in when it comes to these materials, especially gold. I'd like to have a little bit more storage for those. I've already run a preliminary line for copper over here because we are going to be needing a lot of copper. And let's rethink this a little bit here. We've got a little bit of wiggle room when it comes to missile assembly. So for missile assembly, how many of these do I want? Let's start with five.
Crafting.
And then five of these.
Crafting.
Maybe four is a better number because that's perfect for a turntable. Oh, I also need, before I forget, I also need, let's do four of these, and then four of these. Because we need, so my main missile assembly will be over here. And we're obviously covered by a mountain, so I'll have to worry about power in a second. Let's space these out a little bit. Where do I want to put these in my hot bar? Well, I've got the extruders, and the extruders are for gold. So let's just put these here. That's gold wire, and I need copper tubes. So let's put the extruders, pipe extruders, over here. So I want 1, 2, 3, 4 of these, and I can go up like that, put a turntable on top, put this in there, and they should be good to go. Just like that, and I'll have the output coming out. Okay, for gold, similar but a little different. It's because there are kind of cramped quarters here. I could basically run these like this. And then go up and in. And this one can come this way and in. This one can go that way. And this one can come that way. Okay, so there's my gold wire. Now I need basic missile assemblers. A little bit tricky. So let's do this. I'm going to put the wire directly into the hoppers. Or do I want to do that? Yeah, that's fine. Maybe. No, let's not do that. A bunch of gold wire in my inventory, but that's okay for now. Let's look at basic missile assembler. And if I want to space these out, one. So I could come in with that, remove only. And these don't actually need a whole lot of power, so I can actually share power between the two. That will allow me to only use two solar panels. I clear out some space here. That should have enough. Is that not lined up right? No, that's lined up right. Oh, there it is. And then this one. Oop. That one should line up perfectly with that. Okay. And then I want on the top here. And I need some more logistics hoppers. And let's grab a few of these, as well as some missile turrets. I do want to do imbued, but I'm not sure how I'm going to do that yet. So let's look at this. This one, I'm going to want to come out this way. See if that, yep, that works just fine. Let's throw some gold wire, the gold wire I have, just to get rid of it out of my inventory, and then I can do this. That is a tricky situation here. Let's go this way with that. Let's go in here and in there. Should even itself out. It should be fine. So I want these to be all remove only. And then I need to have the copper pipe coming in here, all of these. However, I want to make sure I don't use this space up there, because then the copper wire and it would just get messy. The output. Oh, hoppers. This is a hopper rich build here. Hoppers, I'll just create a whole bunch of those. And how am I for conveyors? Let's get a whole bunch of conveyors. And I got lost. Oh, give me some organics, please. Organics equal more turrets. Okay, so each one of these I can actually put into a system. So the gold is done. I don't really need to worry about that unless there's a huge problem, which I don't anticipate. So we're going to kind of go over the gold and Let's see. We want a hopper on each one of these. Let's make them logistics hoppers. And these are going to be add only. And then we're going to want a fueler system for all of these. And I'm running out of room, of course. So I kind of thought this might be a good place to go up. But I didn't anticipate how much room these are going to take up. Because the fuelers need another set. And these are going to be remove only. And these are going to have the empty missiles going in. And the fueler, let's take that out and put the fueler in. Like so. And another set on top of these. These are going to also be remove only. And these two need power. So let's see what power system, and that is just not ideal right there. So can I put that instead right there and then take this out like that, and then take over here, do the same thing here, and that should have clearance already. So we have the empty missiles going in here. We're going to have the fuel going in here. So the empty missiles are pretty straightforward. The fuel is another story altogether. So let's get the copper in here. I don't really want to run multiple pipes over there. So let's dump everything into a single hopper. And this should be fine for how fast it crafts. And then coming out of here, we're going to want a turntable. Maybe right here. So we're going to need a conveyor coming up. I want to make sure it's not over a hopper or anything. So if we have a turntable here, we can go in here. We can go in here. We can go in right there. Go in right here. It's like that. And then the hopper coming out. I don't want to do the slope thing right now. It's going to take some time. And to make sure this outputs as fast as it can, we can double it up. So these should actually be making missiles right now. It's kind of hard to see. But yeah, that's making missiles now. So now we just need the fuel to come over here. And on that front, I'm thinking maybe we want to... Oh, we can't actually have that there. Or that there. Okay. So, fuel-wise, a similar system, only I think I'm going to use turntables for that. We can put them right in here. top here. That should work. So the fuel can go right in, and it will do just fine. So let's do... up, up, and in. Okay, so the output for these, I kind of want a little bit of storage. So let's put storage hoppers. And these are going to be add only. Okay. So now we've got a little bit of that. We want a couple more hoppers over here for fuel. I'll sort out fuel in a little bit. To get these going initially, though, let's just toss in a couple canisters. And I built some over here, so we should have some over here. Let's fill this up with iron again. And maybe add another iron. Just to make sure we're crafting as much as possible, and as well as biomass. So we've got the copper, we've got all that stuff. I'm gonna go kickstart. Let's build the rest of the OET. Okay, this should be... structure complete. There it is. Okay, there's the orbital thingy up there. And to kickstart it, we are just going to go for it. And as far as missiles go, let's build up a ways and see what we can see up there. So if I just... I need to build up a ways. Because it needs line of sight. And if it doesn't have line of sight, it's not actually going to work. Kind of hard when you're zoomed in to get a good bearing on it. Let's let all those build here. It's a long way up, so let's continue this here. So we are 44 meters up. That's not bad. Kind of out of the way of the diagonal where the attacks are going to come in from. And as far as a platform up here, I want to build out and have a good platform to work with, which is very hard without a cool sneak feature that I've requested many, many times. So I might just go down here and build it out like this. Because I want a nice platform to build stuff with. Oh, the whistle of the Falcors. Okay, let's go over here. like that. It's probably too big, but we are going to be pushing a lot of missiles up there. And, I'd rather have it too big than too small. Because I need this internal space open so I can grapple up. So if I go out over here, build that out, and I can build this out as well. This is looking to be a little much for what I need it for. But a nice area to build with is what I'm going for. Because I'm usually not have enough room on my missile towers. And so I want to remedy that this time around. I can always take away what I don't need. Okay, we got a nice base here to work with. So missile turrets, they need line of sight. And in order to get line of sight, you usually put them on the edges of a tower. So I'm thinking raise it up, and I just do not have the materials. Unbelievable how I can go up there like that and not have batteries and solar panels, all the stuff that I need. Okay, batteries. I probably don't need super batteries, so let's just get what we can. Missile turret, servo motors. Crafting. Missile turret. Crafting. And the last but not least, we want... How many conveyors do we have? 136, that might be enough. We have power, we have storage, turrets. How about hoppers? Logistics hoppers? Okay. But this episode went really long, so I'll pick it up next time. So thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.